Get that online. Should be awesome. Alright, theology next. Start here. There. Keep going here. I want to meet city-states. Probably not going to be able to get through this shit, am I? How about give me open borders? Can I buy open borders in terms of horses? No. Nope. Okay. Alright, missionary down this way. Hangouts. I want that tile. 39 more gold, so 2 more turns. Okay. Trade route was headed that way. It needs to now feed my cap. I need to feed my cap now that I've got my gold stabilized. Capital needs to grow a lot more than it has been. We're going to go to 0 happiness next turn, and then 2 the turn after, huh? Let's temporarily work at least a little bit more gold and slow that growth down. I don't want this one growing. I don't want it. So the problem is, if one of your cities goes unhappy, it screws up the growth in all your other cities. No. That's okay. We don't need open borders, buddy. No. Nope. Could have tried 12 horses. I don't really want to use up all my horses. Alright, let's work the growth tile there. We need stables in my cap. I'm now working, I think, 4 or 5 stable resources, and I have more than I want. Are we really not working this tile? We are working this tile. Okay. Okay. A little bit more GPT. Crazy with this number of units over here. There's a city-state down there. Awesome. Excuse me. Why 1.21 over 1.28? Am I using... I don't know which version I'm using right now. I didn't like the interface of one of the versions. There's nothing special about it. Just don't like it. Alright, gardens are happiness now, too. Right. Should think about that. Capital is going to be so busy, though. It needs to get that stable out. We can build out the gardens in the other cities. Alright, just flip to Kabul as well. I have open borders, right? Yeah, I do. Let's get Buenos Aires. Okay, anything else that needs to happen in here? Can buy it not next turn but the turn after. So one more turn of improving these. There's 4 happiness. We can grow again. Awesome. Let's unavoid growth. Go back to working the tile I want to work. You weren't avoiding growth anyways, nor were you. Cool. Alright. Hello Melbourne. Can we buy it this turn now then? Shit, I just moved. This is the downside. No, I'm 1 gold off anyways. Okay. I think I found a religion with that. They just built Hagia Sophia. Alright, you go there. You go there. Buy the tile now. That's happiness. Because we're trading out so many copies, we can chop that out. We're fine with that. That's better tile than we were working, so that's good. Alright. This city needs growth again. It needs its civil service tiles up, because it's really gross starved before then. And it kind of needs to stop working gold. Alright, I'm just trading which cities have which tiles. This city, because it's going to build a stables and it can grow to the horse for its production tile and actually be useful. Alright. There's going to be some crunching here. Alright, we'll wait for these city-state units to move. Let's chop this out. Build a mine here. Finish this mine, finish this farm. Need more farm tiles on fresh water. Alright, we'll go here and here, start doing that. And again, we're just trying to improve the highest value yields we can out of everything we're doing right away. And I'm prioritizing growth to Tikal because it's not getting a trade caravan, and it's growing slower, and it has to work Kalish, which has no food tile yield on it. Okay. EUI gives you a ton of information that you wouldn't get otherwise. I strongly recommend it. Alright, let's talk about planting great people. That's another one that's worth talking about. I should cycle the one who has... You can only get... In the mod, you can only get a limited amount of experience from killing city-state units. You can only get up to 2 promotions, just like barbs. So you should cycle the ones in that have less than 2 promotions to keep shooting the city-state if you choose to do that. So I have a great profit to plant. It's going to give me a lot of good yield as piety. Where do I want to plant it? And the answer is on non-freshwater wheat, on pasture resources, assuming you don't have a pasture culture resource, and on strategic resources is where you want to plant it, pretty much. So the sheep, the horses, and the wheat are all fine. And I should just plant wherever the quickest one of those is that I'm actually working. In this case, it's horses. So let's just go. But it might not be horses forever, but it's going to be. All right, so we're just going to plant right there on the horse. We do lose the production, but we get a shit ton of yield because we have piety finished, and this is the mod. So the profits are very, very valuable. I don't really want to shoot that guy. Where am I going to put these? Well, I think I'm going to piece the city state. I don't really want any more workers. And what I want to do is start improving these civil service tiles. So let's do that. I want to improve the horses for a circus. And I want to go improve the cow. Let's convert Buenos Aires. Oh, really? That wasn't enough, huh? Yeah, it was. Okay, cool. Why not set on the empty plane style? Because I don't have enough. If you look, so think about that, right? What if I settled on the empty plane style, like this one, for example? Yeah, that's an extra tile, but look at the size of my city. My city's only 8 pop. I already have other tiles I'd like to work. Ideally, I'd be working the 2 silver and the iron, because they're really, really good tiles. The problem is I don't have enough population in my city to be working a whole nother tile just because their yields are really high like this. So rather than basically split up 2 really good yield tiles and have to choose between them, I can combine them with only a very little minimal amount of loss and work all of it right now. So that's the benefit of planting it on one of these existing tiles. I still only lose 1 hammer out of this. That's all I lose from doing this. I still get the stable bonus. I still get the strategic resources. I'm still going to be working the tile. All I lose is the 1 hammer that I would normally have from having the pasture on it. And this way I don't have to work 2 tiles. All right. Alright, why theology? For 2 reasons. The first is we're Maya, so we get the bonus for the long count, the Mayan long count people. And the second is because we have a grand temple benefit. We don't have any temples up, so we got to get temples up, but that's kind of where we're going from that. Alright, I don't have rationalism open yet. That's really unfortunate. I could go commerce, but I'm not. I'm going to go aesthetics because I want the culture. Patronage, if I was going to go with diplomatic victory, sure. I don't really care about the aesthetics for the sake of... tourism, although if I get good enough at that, I can do a tourism victory. But I'm much more interested in just the multiplying power. I invest in culture now and aesthetics before I get to Renaissance, and by the time I finish aesthetics, it's going to give me enough culture, like basically as I just gone into rationalism immediately, which I can't do right now. All right, spread these farms out. This is going to be my guild city. My capital is not big enough right now. It doesn't have enough food per turn to really justify putting guilds in there. So I'm going to want to get a city that has really high food per turn. We can probably even look at this and see this right now. So capital is at 15 food per turn. Palenque right there is at 13 food per turn, even though it's not receiving any trade routes, doesn't have the palace. So I'm probably going to be building a guild slot, either an artist or a writer's guild in that city. And the benefit of what that lets me do is not have my capital have to work so many specialists and be unable to continue growing, because it really needs to continue growing. All right, I should have done a couple open terrain promoted. I went a little overboard with all this rough terrain promotion, but we'll live. Hello, Kiev. All right. Yeah. Piety gives a lot of profit yield if you have it, which is why we took Messiah to combo with getting more profits. All right, we desperately need... I don't really know that I need more military right now. We're in pretty good terms with our neighbor. Let's get temples out. Temples I need to finish for getting my grand temple out, and I would really have liked to have done that a little bit earlier, but didn't. So let's get our temples out. We already have a temple in the cap, though. I don't remember building that. Let's get the stables in there and the temples. The gold per turn I'm going to need to start throwing into buying tiles. My borders are expanding very slowly. This is one downside of piety, and there's lots of freshwater tiles that I really would like to get in my empire. Speaking of... And you guys can see Kabul is now at zero. It's at zero because, as I said, your influence decay, the negative influence decays even though you're at war with them. So all I lost was the ability to fulfill quests for them. And I managed to steal like 6 workers, farm experience, and otherwise have a grand old time over there. So that's pretty good for us. All right, why engineering next? I want to get aqueducts. I don't have access to aqueducts for free. Really, education would be good here, but I'm not going to have the time to do that. So I'm going to go into metal casting to get workshops up. If you look, the production now, this is one of the bad sides of piety. My city production, is, even though I'm having a pretty good game as piety with a lot of worker steals, my city production is still pretty shit. And it's unfortunately going to stay that way for a while. Alright, first long count bonus. Too bad, we just lost Notre Dame. Are there any wonders here that I could take? I could take Anchor Watt. That would let me get a university right now. I'm gonna do that. Am I gonna do that? It will, the Mayan great people aren't actually free. They do increase the cost of your future great people of that type. So I am somewhat tempted to take that so I don't have to build the university in my capital. Because my capital is very, very, very behind in its production. It needs to get its grand temple up. Grand temple is a multiplier in piety. No, I think I'm going to go engineer. We'll get profit soon. All right, will this finish it? This gives me 300. Yeah, it will. Cool. All right, Anchor Watt's a free university in the mod. It's also an engineer point, which isn't terrible either. Alright, I want to improve a freshwater tile on the cap as soon as I can. Cool. Spy. Alright, I'm going to spy... I'm trading 2 luxuries in Indonesia. I'm going to spy China. They have a sailing tech, so I'm going to guarantee some tech steals out of that. All right, I want to keep working food here. Or as much as I can. Only downside of these tiles, they overlap pretty heavily. Are we growing again here ever? Yeah, we just did. I'm going to give all the food to this city for now. All right. My capital seems so bad in terms of its border expansion. It's hard for me to get my head around an 11-turn temple. I know it's on standard speed, but man, 11-turn temple after the 50% multiplier or the half-off multiplier from piety is pretty nuts. Oh shit, I was gonna buy that tile. I guess next turn. Okay. Lake Victoria's happiness. I love how they settled all around it. This is a beautiful Lake Victoria too. This is exactly how you want a Lake Victoria. Well, I guess he is gonna settle it. You want a Lake Victoria around a bunch of hills so that food is actually useful in the early game. But I'm gonna be a little bit careful with spending all my money. I do need crossbows in the near future. And I really should be working those university specialists. But I just can't seem to afford it population-wise right now. I don't have enough growth per turn in my capital to make that a thing. Oh, they wanted a natural wonder. Awesome. Alright, food, food. Work that food. Oh, I'm not working this food either? What? When did we grow there? I didn't notice. Alright, improve this, improve that, keep that going, buy this tile, improve it, That's a tile we can improve in a moment. We have starting to get quite a long queue production-wise, which is really unfortunate. Universities are a long time from now. I really need to work these, but I can't. Alright, at pop 10, I'll maybe start working them, but it's just so painful to work them at an 8 pop city or a 9 pop city. The fact my capital is 9 pop is pretty painful in of itself, so. China's getting warred a lot. Poor bastard. Alright, let's head down this way, get the wheat online when we can. Anything else I want to do this turn? Besides not click on all my workers. City needs its workshop. Oh, my cities need their workshops quite badly now. Alright, I don't want to finish this market. I think I'm going to go workshop here. Getting another engineer would be really valuable too. I don't want a friendship with China. I don't want to piss off Babylon or the Huns. Alright, tile yield's pretty good there. We could chop for a little bit of extra production and start getting other farms up on these tiles. Any freshwater tile should get a farm on in the early game. So, okay, so let's talk about that. This is just a little thing we could talk about. Why? When did you put a freshwater farm on a mine hill, on a hill, on a river, and when do you put a mine? This city, because it has so many growth tiles and so few production tiles, I built a mine there. In the early game, you'd build it on the other, you build freshwater tiles, you build farms everywhere else, pretty much, unless there isn't a production tile there. And the reason why you do that is because the yield you get off civil service is +2 off of a farm, and it's only +1 off of a mine. So, you just get more yield doing it that way, so more overall yield for your city to work. And food is more important than hammers for large portions of the game, because you have to grow your cities. Your cities will grow into production, but they need the food to do that. No. Oh, you have crab. Crabs are King Day in the capital. Which is awesome. I should be hunting down King's Days as much as possible. Pawnees could attack me. I have a reasonable standing army. And I'm teching crossbows right now to deal with the fact that I don't have a huge army. But yeah, Pawnees could attack me. That is true. We done that? We are done that. Alright, let's get a mine up here. Alright, hopefully finishing these temples soon. Can't have open borders, even if you ask twice in two turns. The merchants and the traders have come. I hate that I'm not working my university slots right now. I hate it so much. But I cannot justify the population loss right now. Yeah, my capital will never grow if we don't do that. Well, you know what? You should be building ahead of that workshop. Should be getting our third caravan. So what am I doing here? My cities are getting, these are piety cities. Piety cities, besides the capital, tend to suck. They just tend to not have a lot of production. So what I'm trying to do is use the city with the most extra production, my biggest secondary city, to build some of the things that will allow my capital to build the national wonders it needs to do. Because otherwise I'll never get to all the things I need. As it is, I'm not going to get to all the things I need. But and I'm prioritizing in rough order food into production into science. Food into production into anything else, pretty much. So aqueducts are essentially a food building. The caravan's going to be food. Then we're going to get workshops. And then after then we can get universities. I just don't have the population to make universities a good investment right now. I do plan on building universities, but I'm not, like, look how much time is my cities are going to have to be building. They have like 15 to 20 turns of things they have to build before they could realistically start in universities. You can't build trading posts on bananas. There's not a tile improvement you can make. Alright, another profit. I'm gonna put this guy on the sheep just so I don't have to improve it. I'm already working the sheep, so that should be fine. I've just got another growth tile, let's work it. At the next two population points we grow, we'll work scientists in the cap. I'd really like the city to be working more food. Doesn't have it right now, but when I get this farm online, we can work that. Alright, we were sending trade routes to other cities. I think it's time to send it all to the cap. My cap is suffering immensely from the lack of food it's had from these cities. So let's move to Tikal, send to the cap. We've done this. How long on Grand Temple? We're missing two turns here, huh? Let's get the aqueduct first, and then we can go into Grand Temple. Alright, we can deforest some of these hills just for chops while we're there, just for food while we're there, rather, or production while we're there. Hello, Florence. A lot of cultural city-states in this game. Like, a ton of time. Look, another one. There's three over here in a row. And then we have, like, two over here, right? Yeah, two over here. That's five. I don't think I've ever seen five in a game. It's a lot. Alright, food to the cap. If I could have generated the engineer in that southern city, I would have, because it would have been able to work those slots immediately. It's not a good tile for it to be working. We're missing growth tiles in these cities in the long run. 25 tiles is too slow of a growth for the next population point. We're going to start really regretting these city settles if we're not careful. Alright, so we can Grand Temple here. Farm there. There. I need to get guilds up in this city. Maybe after the workshop we can start. What are we working right now? That tile, I'd rather even two food than that. Okay. No regrets, Aqua? No. I don't know that I find vanilla deity any harder than this, than deity here. You just have less options, you just have to go tradition rationalism every time. Just not that exciting. I don't necessarily think that 8 is any harder than 6, you just have to do more in the way of science-related victories as opposed to anything else. Just seems like all you're changing by making those criteria that you've just laid out, making the game more boring. We're not last in tech anymore, you guys see that? It's good. Alright, time to start working. Oh, man. I want to work an engineer slot so bad so I can engineer some wonders ever again. I mean, I'm not worried about late game science. I guess I'm going to take a workshop. Oh. Alright, how's happiness at 3? We're never going to get to doing anything I want to do in this city because production is just too low. Let's chop out the freshwater tile to encourage the border growth. Okay. Crossbows. Hybrid. I mean, look, we're still going to hit university techs ages before we're ready to build universities. Another trade route to the cap. I guess Chitsun isn't sending in one right now. I have crossbow tech. Let's upgrade some crossbows. 100, huh? That's quite a lot. Yeah, Liberty's an option. We've done it. We've done a Liberty game before. You don't tend to want to settle quite as many cities as you would versus a human player, but it's certainly an option. GPT ended. I wonder for what. Just chop here. Just chopping tiles. I can chop out to help my borders will expand 5 tiles out to the furs eventually, even tundra furs like that. I just have to give them a lot of encouragement, like chop everything out along the way. I would like another blocker unit, but I understand that other things. Oh, nice, freshwater tile expanded into my borders. Or my borders expanded to a freshwater tile, rather. Alright, another trade route to the cap. Alright. Yep, I'm fine with this. I need cocoa and sugar. I wonder if anyone has those. No. Or rather, they only have a single copy. I could try them. You guys would have said like 25 horses. Let's give them 16 horses. 15 horses for this sugar. I will take cultural centers. Still not in Renaissance, so let's get a little bit further down that tree. We're not done this farm anytime soon. We are. Let's work that tile. Get as much growth as we can. Yeah, we literally don't have a tile for the city to work. That's how freaking sad it is right now. The city needs a specialist, so we'll get that workshop up when we can. Let's chop this out. We're gonna go build some weird farms like here. Okay. Alright, workshop's up so we can build the rest of the buildings, including universities, at a more reasonable rate. This feels like slow university tech, but it might just be that our tech is way ahead of our production as piety. There's happiness on the Grand Temple, so that will help some of our stuff when we get there. Wine ended down here for what? What were we trading? Wine for what? Pearls? Yeah, we don't have two wine anymore, right? Oh, but no, I want that. I want to keep this trade. Because I'm trading wine away for a one-for-one for crab, and I'm okay with that. That one ending. That was just for the King's Day. I wonder if I could afford to buy a King's Day for one of these cities. Probably not. Oh, and I have luxury right here that I've forgotten about for a very, very long time. Let's go get that. Totally forgot about that. It's expensive to buy it behind the mountain. Alright. What was that? Why do I have an unassigned tile here? Let's work the first of our university specialists. When is our next profit? Couple turns. Let's not fuck that up then. Let's take a great scientist. Again, same rationale for where you plant this on a tile, you can work. I'm going to plant this on inland wheat like this, not freshwater wheat. It's not a bad thing at all to plant on that, because I'm only going to lose one yield, just like I'd lose on another tile. How long on border expansion? 17 turns, we just grew to this shitty tile, but that shitty tile is better than what we were working, so we'll work that. Chop this out. Keep scouting. Alright, education next turn. Grab physics after. What are we stealing? 21 turns. Ugh. Alright. Workshops. Oh, hold on. Workshop's done. Yeah, that's fine. You can keep buying that. No. No open borders for you. Market's up. That's good. Have a university in there.